Nation Smash that happened yesterday, in which the French Nation Smash team defeated the American one.
15 seconds here to go. Teams we get going. I will take a look at the team here starting on the
10,
southern side of the base.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
T.O.R. starting on the southern side then. One brightly clad LA. Three heavies and a second lot assault, in fact, as well as a bolter for the T.O.R. Prioritizing roof control here over punch
BS
power
with a
inside.
stronger push. Four heavies and double LA, no board for them.
Able to get the first pick on the roof here with their Serpents, confirming one kill and forcing the other lot assault back off. Cleaning up eventually are the LAs for VS. Dirtle here going down, getting one tapped by a commissioner. Naken, I believe, with that kill. Internally, it went initially in favor of Blaguettes, picking up quite a number of kills inside on behalf of their heavies. The light assault's able to come in and finish off the proceedings.
Extremely strong play from number 88 on the VS side, staying alive somehow in between two heavies and an LA and taking skimp down with his commie. Good pick from Jordo with his Sound 42 on the back of the point on Smosters, and Skimp goes down as well as Jordo. Strong showing from FRPC on the start of the game.
Dirtle down to a decimator, so no points will go over there. But point control does go to the French side here. The absence of Aflick, maybe their star player last night, hurting them possibly. Hard to tell at this stage, where things are not really decided. Nice double kill there from Skimp, turning around to help his buddy, taking down both Skulls and Jarustin. Naken with a nice double kill. Dirtle and Quoted both going down to his Serpent. Lynx and a Jaguar, I believe, being wielded by the T.O.R. Light Assault pairing as they look for a push here across the rooftop.
Well, nice EMP from Durdle. Could be. Oh, yes. One goes down and a second one. And CrossGen already on the flank.
Nice play from Quoted there. Light Assault and Buddy in trouble, but able to get the pick.
This was a key fight for the match, as I think it was a clean wipe from Joke. After starting behind on kills.
Joke lose one player there, in fact. Quoted goes down to Meron. But apart from that, Quoted with a triple kill, which does enable them to get complete control of the internal area.
Skimp goes down on the lobby area.
Dirtle peeking aggressively
Dirtle
there
peeking.
and able to escape. Despite being chased by a pairing of heavies, I believe. Push here onto point for the VS. Heavy jumping down over the big stairs. It's one kill. Second for him, in fact.
And the point is safe. 3 seconds to go.
Yeah, clutch resecure there for the Frenchies. One crowd having to push in from behind, but goes down, as does his buddy Crossjean.
Oh, if RPC needs a strong hold now that they stabilize the match. Went again ahead on kills, I assume.
Kills 50-50, in fact. They both have, or 52-52, to be precise. Massacre here, though, is two VS players jump down in the midst of three TOR clearing up all the heavies. Using two of their own, in
close
fact.
To going down. Crossjung goes down on the bridge area. Naken on roof control with the other light assault. One LA goes down for the French team.
Naken with another commissioner pick.
Naken going big for the French team.
Yeah, sitting on 12 currently. Similarly, is quoted on the opposite side. Quoted over playing heavy. Four-man push onto short stairs. Traded one for one between French Life and Crossjung, I believe. But interior control back in favor of Tior.
Roof control for FRPC, no TR light assaults. Crossjung coming back.
Beers attempting to push in, but a double kill for Dirtle and Quoted. Although the latter does go down. It's a slight lead here. 8 points in kills, 10 points in kills. And a minute away from the neutral point in the base capture. Joke slightly leading. I'd actually like to win this fight. Another French push there, successful. Naken with two, taking down both his opposing lot assaults. Commissioner trade on point.
Crossjung takes down one on the bridge flank. Ooh, Naken with a great shot on Crossjung. It takes Juan Quao down. 1v2, takes both LAs down. Great play from him.
Naken has been impressive so far with his commissioner, in fact.
It goes down to Dirtle in the end.
Three kills in a row there for the Tior side, still lead by a minute on the base cap and 10 points overall here, when all is said and done in that push.
Quoted going aggressive on server. Joke on control of the roof.
Three seconds left on cap and server room almost deserted. VS pushing in now. Dirtle with an aggressive pick.
Juan Quao takes down Naken on the roof.
Yep. 7 seconds remaining. Once more the VS are able to pull things out and get the point back here. Still a 10-point deficit in kills. It's quoted goes for a flank. Could have getting two there as Crossjung goes down.
Juan Quao goes down on point.
Flurry of players on both sides here looking to push. Flanked though from Naken with his 11C. Gets down one player and harasses the remaining. Double kill for both Maroon and Jarostein. Forcing the Tior away.
This is a brawl of a game. So many kills going back and forth.
But just like that, 10-point lead is re-established for the joke backs mix rusty or baguettes. Able to get some nice picks there on the roof with both VS Light Assaults going down.
And trades going in favor on point for the Frenchies. Dirtle pushing Smosters.
Yeah, Dirtle getting surprised by a lot of assault from behind as he attempts to push there. Unable to capitalize on what is an aggressive push as a bolt action.
Cross zone on the roof, being spotted by the upcoming heavies.
The high cap mag at the NS15M then, compared to a Lynx pinning down Cross John.
And Huang Kuo went down. Root Dominance against for the LA duo from the American team. Hold it going down.
1 minute on the cap. VS looking for another push.
Yellows goes down again. And Skim too. So, point. Clear for FRPC.
Closer game than I would have anticipated, actually.
Yeah.
FRPC coming around pretty strong here. Particularly led by the Light Assault play. Making with some good movement there to stay alive. Does go down, however, pushed by three players.
Concussion nades going on the corridor, on lobby. Door one flank for a VS Heavy, takes down Dirtle.
Brenos there getting two. But up towards the plateau area, it is Tior who are still in command with 22 seconds left on cap here. Currently leading by a margin of 30 points in kills, as well as the potential for a base cap here in 10 seconds worth 24 points.
Which is likely to happen at this point.
Yeah, with 3 seconds left here, it's imperative VS get on the point now. Their player does go down and the base is captured here by Joke. Nice 1v1 victory there for Jarosteen, despite being disadvantaged. No potential here for a recap, given the initial one took so long to acquire here for Joke. Them leading now by approximately 60 points. Interesting note here in chat, the NS15M players not doing as well as the Orion wielding VS heavies. With both Skulls and French Life, who would have thought to be strong players here, going negative. Whereas Merun and Jarosteen doing better with their Orions.
Yeah, the lower DPS pays the price of the 75 ADS on these shorter ranges inside the Ganan building.
Yeah, I feel Hipfire, which is also somewhat important here, is lacking on the NS15M comparatively.
Naken takes down mid air, Huang Kuo. Gets traded by Crossion.
46 seconds remaining in the half. Well, was a good one actually for most of its duration. Despite the 50 approximately point differential between the sides now, it was much closer until the base cap went through. T teams neck and neck for most of the half.
Still, it's doable for FRPC. If they get a cap and some good kills on the second half, they'll be right back there. So, not over at all.
Both teams 10, have to be
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. End of first half.
Alright, with the first half over. Whilst I have missed two of the kills there at the end, the admin script is the one with the final result. But on my side, it looks like approximately a 68-point differential. So I would imagine for the actual ref then, the score then will be 72 points difference between the sides. Quoted, doing well here for his side, an 18-point net score. So we will switch over here to the halftime score sheet. Any thoughts here on the performances, Dwayner? What can be improved on for the second half, etc.?
Well, good performance from FRPC. Sadly, the cap went through for the North Americans, but until that point, it was extremely close. Really good performance from them. They had a rough start on the tournament, and they were missing some players. Skulls, the leader, not being able to show for some games. And now, giving us all a good show, so happy for them. What can they do better for the next half? It's very, very, very important for FRPC to not lose complete control of the roof, because I expect Joke Bugs mixed in to use more the roof heavy than the French deep. So it's extremely important for them to use it. In the other side, it's really important for Bugs Joke to exploit that. And if they get a cap, which this team is capable of doing so because it's their specialty. This is an outfit that on live server goes to usually underpop fights and hold points. They have anything in front of them. They can take this win if they have a good second half. 40 points, 50 points, I'm not sure what's the differential at the moment, but it's not that big. If they have a strong start, I think they can recover. And Joke, just push it as much as you can. Get that roof control, lock them out, farm them, extend your lead, win the game.
The difference is currently 72 points for your information, winner. And for those on the stream, despite what I have, there's also an extra 2 kills that went in favor of the Joke side, as well as a base capture of them were 24 points.
Yeah, 70 is a bit of a bigger lead, but still doable. Getting the cap and not allowing Joke for a recap in that scenario is absolutely necessary for the Frenchman.
It'd be interesting to see what the Joke team decide to do in terms of heavies on the roof, for example. Not something really utilized by the French side here, but maybe their American counterparts can do somewhat better.
Well, Naken was killing everyone, so it's not like they they needed it that much.
With the base ready here, we're for the teams to ready up, and we will get this half underway. Hopefully it'll be good and close like the last one was, despite the difference in scoreline at the end. Nice close match for both sides.
Both teams ready. 1 minute to go.
We'll start in 1 minute.
Starting here in 1 minute to enter, then any final thoughts again?
Nothing, just expect to see a good second half as they provided us with in the first one.
I'll be looking for Skulls and French Life to pick it up a bit. Both of them I know to be strong heavies, you know, on live. Particularly French Life is able to get some of that high KPM gameplay in, but currently here unable to pull it out for his team. Messing on a negative net score right now. Twenty seconds here then till kickoff of this half. Should have two more games coming up after this, however, with the winner of this game playing actually again later
10,
on.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, start.
Checking out the Tior here then. Frostjohn standing out with his bright red camo. Forsaking one of their light assaults as Crossjohn is now heavy.
Interesting, no LAs for the BS team. All of them get EMP'd by the way on Bixers. Nice EMP from Dordu.
Interesting, as that usually is the side where the double LA does come out.
Huang Quao going to door 3. Oh, nice crossfire in between Huang Quao and... And Crossjohn taking down the heavy on door 2.
Tior players here caught between enemies on both sides. There's aggressive play from the Bolter. Aiken works out for him there, getting a nice pick on Skimp at close range. Dirtle taking out Breno, so one kill apiece for the Bolters.
Crossjohn going up again on the roof.
Yeah, VS able to establish early point control here, it seems.
So, Huang Quao already in door 1. Going down the stairs on the swamp, waiting for Crossjohn probably. Crossjohn goes down.
He gets one kill as he goes down there, so not working out too badly for him.
Joke on control of the building. They now are gonna try to lock out the Frenchman. Huang Quao holding roof for them.
Pushing the inside here from the Frenchies. Four heavies inside. Pushing past Skimp though, as one player does go down, unaware of his presence.
FRPC, stop using Gen 1 SMGs. Eridani is not allowed.
Aiken. Using a weapon he's not allowed gets a warning. Any further infraction of the rules for their side will result in a 25 point deduction. Your referee on the ball there, and able to call them out on that one.
Looks like if RPC is opting for a heavy push strategy to get the cap. Going in really fast, trying to take down their opponents. Right now, getting shot in the back by Huang Quao in door 2.
Dirtle with a nice push though, picking up two kills against heavies with his commissioner. Some impressive aim from him there to pull that out.
Naken takes out Huang Quao. You can still gut this out. And getting on the point. Dirtle attempting some bolt shots across the bridge.
Crossjohn on the roof there, taking out Brennos. Made a lot of assault, despite the buff, unable to win that one. We can still
win this. And dropping door 1, the tier heavy. Crossjohn has to back off. And in the meantime, Huang Quao takes down the BS light spot. Nice shot from Naken, taking down Crossjohn. 1.5 to go on the cap.
VS being whittled down slowly though. Tior getting control of the server area. They're looking for a pick on short. Gellos pushes in from behind with Huang Quao.
Spawn Qual goes down. And now FRPC establishing the crossfire in front of the server room. Baxio with a passive approach. They know they are ahead on the kills. Even the cap will not get FRPC ahead. Crossion on the roof above the bridge, door 3, drops down. Oh, he misses the heavy and the heavy misses him. Now he reacts and takes him down.
Internally, Dirtle will be able to pick, able to resecure the point for the Tior here. 30 seconds.
Dirtle is having a great match.
Yeah, sitting on a 26 net score, currently the highest on his side with 23 kills. Quote, despite having more kills, has gone down more, so that's the nature of being a heavy. Playing aggressively against some French players who are able to pull it out 1v1 here.
Knife fight! Quoted flanking door 3. Cleans up. Nice flanks from coming in from the North American team.
For sure. 9 minutes remaining in the match. 3 minutes on the capture. But easily enough time to get one in here.
Interesting enough, the North American team, having control of the point, pulled out and allowed the Frenchmen to recover. Probably willing to set up again their flanks and sandwich the French FRPC team again and keep growing their lead in frags.
There was another nice pick there.
Is this the best you have? Dordal and Skimp both go down on server room, only Crossion left, get CMP'd.
And Naken taking out his opposite number with 30 seconds on the cap. Joke leading by still a similar margin to the first half, but will lose 24 points of that safety buffer. The cap goes through here in 20 seconds for the VS. Looking more and more likely as the time goes on. Well, able to get a decisive push here on short stairs. To 1 second remaining here. Dirtle jumping down in desperation, but too late. Currently a 60, mid-60s point differential for in the size with 7 minutes remaining. Recap though, if Joke were to get it, they would get approximately double the difference in the teams with a 48 point reward for a recapture here.
Crossion in the roof. And with Juan Quao both take down the French light assault. Juan Quao dropping door 2. Trading with French life.
Naken getting some nice picks here as Bolt in the second half, though.
Okay, Naken is going big.
Crossjaw and Gallows for him there.
Oh, Bolt action trade. Both Naken and Dordo go down at the same time on the server room.
Tior pushing, attempting to make a push back into server room, leaves instantly. He sees the area is empty, waiting for his side to push back in.
Yeah, I think FRPC needs to get aggressive now. They need to push as much as they can, try to lock backs out of the building, and get as many kills as they can. 6 minutes to go, and they are 60 points down just on frags due to both teams having a base gap. So they really need to get aggressive now and try to get as many kills as they can.
Two are being pushed back out of server room though. Only 1 minute remaining for them to get on point if they wish to get a recap here. But not necessary for them as they do lead overall, as you said.
Dordle takes down the light soul from the Sandy almost. Crossjohn and Juan Quao both on the roof. Juan Quao dropping door one. Goes down to who I think is a Skulls.
Because it's French life's force blade, in fact. Though Crossjohn trading that one out. Pushing in and taking down Naken also. Claiming point control here. Just over 4 minutes remaining. Frenchie's looking for a push here. Dirtle and Gelos get picks each.
Well played from Gelos. Holding his ground. Dordo, oh my god.
Dordo using the unpredictability of the stairs to his advantage there with a number of nice shots.
Dordo was absolutely key to hold down that push. Very well played.
Despite not getting all the kills, he might get body shots Gellos, there, so.
Double LA coming in for FRPC. About to drop down on the double doors. They jumped on a heavy. And they failed to take him down, and now they get sandwiched.
Turtle left on point here. Faced by multiple heavies as they attempt to push down short simultaneously. He does go down, but Juan Kyle picks one up at his links.
Start fighting for real at any time now.
Crossjohn on the roof, plus Juan Quao, and double LA from the Frenchman.
I just saw a dual win by the French. Both are lot of souls on the roof currently. Crossjohn takes one out, but goes down to the second one. Defense of the facility by the VS, so no possibility now of a recapture.
Skimp goes down on lobby against 15 him. And looks like Joke is gonna take this game home unless we see a big improvement kill wise from the French.
Yeah, with 2 minutes, it looks unlikely that they will get 70 points here, I believe, that they require to make up the difference.
Yes, but good performance from them. It was a close game for the most part.
Yeah, back and forth at times. Each team getting a capture. Rocket launcher, MLG-7 kill there on short stairs. With 90 seconds remaining.
EMP goes on Bigsters, hits both players.
Little attempts to push, but does go down.
Yeah, he gets body shot and then traded. Yeah, he got body shot by Naken though.
From Buoyantly Dressed, Crossjohn pushing up here, but assistance is unneeded as Skimp and Quoted get kills there in the on the plateau. 50 seconds remaining. Unlikely the scoreline will change at this point, and we will see Joke progressing on with FRPC being eliminated from the tournament here in 40 seconds. Joke's next game will then be, I believe, later on tonight against Red Mist, victors of the prior game. Aiken gets a pick there. Dirtle taken down by a serpent from short stairs. With 16 seconds remaining,
ten,
it's unlikely.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. End of match.
Match over now. We'll look at the final scoreboard as Baguette's move on to the next phase of the tournament. Obviously, Dirtle coming in big with a 34-point net score with 37 total kills. His bolt having a significant impact here. The two light assaults, though, Naken, who did switch the bolt later on and did well there himself, and I believe it's Merrin, both doing well as light assault in the first half for the French side, who were able to get a cap in the second.